There's not much background about these pieces, but what we do know is from letters that Tchaikovsky wrote to his patron and confidant, von Meck. On April 30th, 1878, Tchaikovsky wrote, "Tomorrow I will begin a collection of miniature pieces for children. For some time, I have been thinking that it would be good to contribute, to the best of my abilities, to the enrichment of musical literature for children, which is very important. I want to write a whole series of short and simple pieces with titles to attract children, as Schumann did." The first draft was composed at his sister's home in Ukraine from May 1st through the 4th in 1878. It was then revised in her country home in July. The pieces were published in November that same year in Moscow. The final published copy included small pictures based on the pieces that were engraved on the title page and the table of contents. Tchaikovsky wrote to his publisher, "I regret that I did not think to ask you to print it in another format. What he's meaning here is printing it horizontal instead of vertical. Bodovia will have to play standing to see the notes." This was his nephew, and he dedicated the pieces to him. Tchaikovsky's manuscript score with all 24 pieces is now preserved in the Glinka National Museum Consortium of Musical Culture in Moscow. Like I mentioned before, Tchaikovsky based this album off of Schumann's. Schumann's Opus 68 is a forerunner of the album for the young genre and is based on poems, children's stories, folk tales, dances, nature, and hymns. Schumann's album made a big impact on Laura Deal states it reformulated the experience of childhood, attempting to activate the pleasurable inner world of the imagination through music that was well-crafted, emotive, and responsive to the literary and visual arts. Schumann wrote this collection because he felt that there was a poor quality of music while his daughter was learning the piano. A big part of Schumann, as well as his teacher, Frederick Wieck's pedagogical ideas include readiness, sequencing, and presentation of material that is appealing to children's imagination and fantasy. During this time, there were around 9 different piano methods that were published in England, France, and Germany by composers such as Hook, Turk, Pleyel, Dussek, Clementi, and a few others. Most of these composers focused on the technical and mechanical aspect of playing. For example, Hunton's instruction for the pianoforte, as well as Hertz's complete method for the piano, Opus 100, suggested that the first of 3 hours of practice should be devoted to just scales and technical exercises. Hummel wrote over 2,000 exercises for the piano. Here on the slide, we have an example of Czerny's Opus 337. This consisted of 40 daily exercises for the piano, and in the preface, he stated they should be repeated 20 times until perfected at the tempo given. This is just the first line of the example number 1. Like Schumann's pieces, Tchaikovsky's album for the young has descriptive titles and contains character pieces. Schumann thought that students should work on much more than the mechanical practice before getting to real music. From a young age, it is important for students to develop artistry and sensitive listening. Character piece is designed to convey a specific mood, scene, atmosphere, or illusion without a text or program. Character pieces are a miniature form, so normally around 1 to 3 pages in ABA form. Character pieces allow the student to go beyond the notes on the page and instead experience an emotion or story. Tchaikovsky's album for the young contains different genres about children's life, dances, and songs. Here I have a list of the different children's life pieces, and a few of them include pieces about toys, such as a hobby horse, a wooden soldier, and dolls. There are 3 different dances. We have a waltz, a polka, and a mazurka, and different songs. Within the dances and songs, students get to experience a genres and discuss some of the technical and musical challenges, as well as practice strategies that students can work on. So we'll begin with the children's life genre. There are three different pieces that include a doll. There's the new doll, the doll's illness, and the doll's funeral. Sometimes you'll see one or two of these pieces in different anthologies, but I think it's really great for a student to learn all three of them. The new doll is very upbeat with a left-hand choral accompaniment and is the most difficult of the three pieces. Next is the doll's illness, and I'll discuss this in a moment. And then the doll's funeral. The doll's funeral is a funeral march with dotted rhythms, and 1/4 of the pieces in the album for the young contain dotted rhythms. So some of the technical and musical challenges in the doll's illness include a thin texture, levels of sound and balance, finger independence, and phrasing. So here we have the opening, and notice in the score you can see the clear three textures, and also each texture has a different note value, rhythmic value. A lot of times students work on balance in the manner of bringing out the right hand melody and keeping the left hand accompaniment quieter. But in this piece, students can bring out the outer voices as well as the inner voices. In the beginning, students can practice just the left hand alone for the first line to make sure we can really hear our bass note and keep the inner voice quieter. Then on the second line, starting at measure 9, we can do the opposite with the right hand since we now have two voices within one hand. Students can also practice just playing the outer voices. So jumping to measure 35 through 42, if a student were to just play the outer voices, all we would hear is repeated Gs. So this is where we would need to bring out the inner voices. And I will demonstrate that for you. In the middle of the piece, we have a long 13-bar phrase. Students can also practice just the outer voices here to really listen for the level of decay, especially in the right hand, since we have a 1/4 note rest. And they can really work on shaping the long phrase. And I'll demonstrate that for you. One more piece from the children's life called Sweet Dreams. This is a level 6, and I'll show you how you can transfer some of the same practice strategies from the doll's illness and apply them to this piece. So some of the technical and musical challenges include balance, accompaniment pattern and finger independence, creating a long melody line, pedaling, and rubato. Here's a list of the practice steps that a student can use. So practicing the left hand alone first, you can play the bass note and just ghost play the inner voice. Then play the bass note and exaggerate a soft, light staccato inner voice. Then students can play just the outer voices, right hand alone to shape the 8-bar phrase, and then play as written. Here's the opening, and I will demonstrate for you the left hand practice strategy. So first, I will ghost play the inner voice, and so you won't actually hear it, but you can. The student will exaggerate, but keeping a light inner voice. And then I will show you how they're going to play the bass note, lightly of the